Talk about, I guess, constituent facing services for tracking what people, you know, connecting constituents and citizens with their senators or with their governments in powerful ways and new ways. And so the specific thing that at the Senate we're sort of tasked to do, a senator came up with this idea of officing. I want a sort of 311 for my district so that, you know, I can say, hey, you know, Joe voter, I know what you worry about and care about, and I can help you fix it. Even though they're not a 311 system themselves, the senator can maybe take action on this information. So we have, we were sort of tasked with this, and it was like, well, as the Senate, we don't really have the resources to build the 311 system, and it doesn't make sense for us to reinvent one, so how can we tie into other services? You know, we do have the mobile application, iPhone and Android, so we can use GPS, and we could kind of hack something in there, and you know, we have open ways for people to report issues, but, you know, again, the idea was, through the channels we already have, how can we empower this sort of service, but also how do we tap into new channels? So the idea of working with C-Click-Fix made a lot of sense in that here's a service that has a ton of data already and users and people reporting, but they don't necessarily have a place to route it. And so to think about with our constituent management systems or how to plug that in, and also with our apps, how to plug in the API into our own app. So that's what we're doing at the Senate, and the C-Click-Fix guys have been working with us to make it real. So otherwise, I guess the other part is once we get the data, then you're taking responsibility and saying we're going to do something with it, so you don't want it to go into a black hole. So there's kind of the ethical responsibilities of building an app like this as well.
Do you want to, Ben, do you want to kind of just diagram like how C-Click-Fix and like where the public apps and the API kind of like sit into the framework of C-Click-Fix?
Sure. Do you want me to do a Visio? You're probably better at that.
Sure.
Delegation? Delegation, delegation.
Yeah. You want the mic, Jeff?
Here.
Sure. I can hold his mic for him.
That's true delegation.
Okay, so if C-Click-Fix is here, we stand up services on the front end, which might be the API, that allows for the mobile applications to interface with here. And on the back end of this would be an ability to plug into CRM systems here. So I think what the Senate is talking about is both integration at this point and integration at this point, where they could use our API to on their mobile platform and on their mobile application. So I guess on a technical level, C-Click-Fix sees interacting outside of itself in two ways. One is the API, which is which makes C-Click-Fix sort of passive in its interaction with external sources, and the city governments may pull information from us and push information into our system. And then the other interface is sort of a back-end integration interface where C-Click-Fix is the active participant. It will push information into CRM systems and then pull CRM systems APIs to check on the status updates. So really that's the difference between these two different integration points.
Is there an API on the CRM end for us to push stuff back?
There is, yes. We have document API. You can pull issues, you can check issue status, you can check service requests and service request structures, and then push that information back into CycliFix. Right. So from the CycliFix data structure, we allow service requests to be defined based on a geographic boundary. So you can make an outline of Senate District 52 and say that in that district we allow these types of service requests, and we also allow for second tier questions on the service requests, like if there's a street light out, what is a pole number, questions like that. So that the API is all part of that, and the API, it works on the mobile phones, it works on the mobile web, that those service requests and second tier questions is across all of our interfaces. Technical questions, or?
It's the integration we're talking about now is email, right, into our CRM.
Well, there are a number of different integration points that we could engage in. One of them is a simple email, because CycliFix at the very front end, if the issue is tagged or sent into CycliFix, it can dispatch an email to a particular email address. Our CRM would then read and parse that email address and enter it as an action or just as a record. And that's one way of doing it. The other way is to develop and spend more time and create an API, or at least an interface to the API, that allows for bidirectional connection. So any action that's taken within the CRM, it can be flagged as a public action that would then pump out to the anything that's been tied, you know, through the CycliFix, then gets also publicly reported onto CycliFix, and that's an opportunity that we could address here. That if we want.
Well, I can talk about being a consumer and user of the API. So what we've been doing is consuming the CycliFix data via the API, and also presenting cases back in via the API. Mm-hmm. So really, to use the data, last I checked, there were four different formats for it. Basically, whatever type of XML you want, you go there, and in the request you say, I want this as Atom, or I want this as GORSS, or I want this as, you know, one of the sort of, you know, four standard types of geodata that you could want, and the data's there for you to consume, say, it's a new case. So the act of grabbing that data, it is just straightforward XML, and then pushing back the other way, it's pretty much just encapsulated in the GET. So all you need for that is an API key from these guys, and then you can just go and grab the data as you need it, push the data back in as you want to. And it'll be very similar to all the things that you're already doing in your Drupal site. So the way that your feeds already work will be compatible. It's just a case of what the CRM end of that looks like with your CRM. And obviously with your old help desk system, it's going to be much harder than with your newer Civi CRM system.
And then, so in terms of that workflow, thinking if a user submits via the mobile app, and then I store these their cases in our app, and then it goes through, and I mean, it would all just trickle back up. You'd update the status of the CRM, it would push back, and then if I was pulling for my cases that I've submitted via the API mobile, it would update there, and then any rendering you did publicly would also update, I guess. I think that's what we would want from the senator perspective, is if we're, you know, it's going to be public. If they're saying, oh, put a bunch of tickets in this other service, essentially, or use the app, that we want to make sure those are closed or addressed publicly as well, if we close them in our system. But I know right now we're just doing this email thing, but yeah, I think we probably need to quickly move to another direction, or else we're going to have a bunch of unresolved tickets or whatever the terminology is, right? But we'd rather have, like, the senator with his thumbs up, you know, her thumbs up. Problem solved. So that's our idea, and maybe, I don't know if I'll actually have time to write a line of code today, but if I do, I did look at that API just for submitting a ticket. So the vision is on our, our more menu to have like report a problem in your district, and then it's some subset, you know, maybe not the full tree structure of like what's the number on the pole, but that's something to work together on and just, you know, say, you know, we just want to drive more utility into our app. So if it's like, find your senator, and then also, oh, it's on the senator bot, page two. So find your senator in the app, and then there's report a problem. And so they, I think that's a natural thing that we want people to do, is they report an issue they think their senator would address, you know? And so we'll see how that is. But I think UI-wise, we'll do that, and the initial will just be very simple. We won't do any of the long-term case management. We'll just submit a ticket and say, hey, you, now would they get an email or any confirmation?
Yeah, they get an email confirmation.
So if we ask them in the mobile app, give us your email and we'll send you an email confirmation.
And they get email they get email updates on everything they want. So acknowledgement, closed issues, a congratulations message.
And they might get it from you and from our CRM, right? It might be two messages.
How are we handling it now?
You can brand our emails.
Right.
You can write, you know, the message and the imagery and stuff. So.
Well, just, that's something to think about, because I know I didn't.
So not
we have our case internal case systems in our CRMs.
Sure.
One thing I'd be interested in is, I think this is the first time we're like seeing people kind of branch out to the state senate level. I imagine that some issues that come through are not going to be necessarily down to a lat long. It would be interesting to see how we best handle those and if it's the best use case. I mean, do we flag those on like the senator's house or something?
Right.
Or, yeah, I don't know.
Yeah. Well, people will be sitting on their couch
right.
And want to report a problem.
I mean, we can, obviously, you can report an issue where you aren't sitting or going to GPS, but.
Right. They can point to it on a map.
Yeah.
Do you support more than a point? Do you support boxes? Could they draw a circle?
We don't right now. I mean, it could come up with like large road infrastructure changes, like that kind of stuff. But
yeah.
I imagine that's some kind of business process we'll have to look into.
When it comes down to like contaminants, like how like when people are talking about pollutants or trash or anything like that, I mean, are people historically tagging multiple points?
So if you if you say a park has a lot of litter, someone will just usually
just tag the park,
yeah.
Or at least a close proximity to it.
Right. Yeah.
I mean, depending on how much workflow you've got here, there's possibly something that we've done at Maine or Texas that might tie in well, where the seed fix feed is being used for handling everything that's geo-based, but then we're handling cases with no geo-basis via our CRM.
Right.
So we're kind of creating a hybrid approach there where we're pushing everything that comes into the non-CCLIC fix interface back into CCLIC fix, just because that's where it should have gone to start with. And then also, if there's something that's non-geo specific, handling that. Where we're doing that is where we're bringing in the value around the workflow, so making sure the checks are in place and those kind of things. Just put us into context, we supply forms and CRM for about a third of UK city government, that's kind of my thing. We've got that kind of possibility as well, where we can plug in to provide some of that workflow that you might need or want.
Yeah, I guess, I mean, we could, they could choose, is this sort of about a specific place, or is it just, you know, an issue? And I mean, we have the ability for them to contact their senator directly, so the question is, when do we shove them that way versus, you know, specifically report a problem? And
that's probably a better way to have it. That makes sense.
Yeah, so we'll, and we also, this will change as we do our own CRM integration. Right now, it's just a web form for contact your senator. So.
Yeah, I was going to say, having the service request categories there really helps the conversation
So you can help us do that, kind of the way we're, I mean, I know your app and I can look at what you've done, but that's sort of, I don't think Andrew or Noel or any of it, or the senator knows what exactly how they want to frame it, but but I think we can take it there and then do a few revs on that pretty quickly. So, and I guess in general, for me, in terms of, I don't know our timing, but you know, sometime in September we'll put out a new version of all the mobile apps. So it'd be nice to have it in there.
And
we could do it in parts. Like I could submit C-Click Fix before, well, I guess we need the back end to say that it's going to submit.
I've also, I don't know, I kind of have a thought that if local government is handling a problem, then you don't necessarily get the state senate to step in, right? It's I kind of wonder if, like, in some way state senators are like, you know, you get an issue is open for 90 days and there's a certain level of engagement, whatever, and you, then it gets pushed up, and it might be a way of looking at it as well. Thinking specifically about, like, New York City, one thing that we've heard is that 311 does not handle heating complaints well enough, and they're not, though it's like the highest complaint in the winter. It's something that's definitely, it's flooded over to our system because people don't have faith that, that 311 is going to hold their landlords accountable, or the people that 311 are passing the issue to and hold them accountable. And so at some level, that kind of thing does need to get passed to the other people that represent them. Other elected officials besides Mayor Bloomberg that represent them to assist in that, and you know, it's a probably question whether that happens real time or it happens when it becomes more of a problem when they're not being represented quickly.
I think that there are like certain characters of like how a senator could want to watch some of that data, or at least a statewide elected official would want to watch some of that data. You know, let's think of a state agency like the Parks Department, you know, geo-tagging and cutting out all the different parks properties that are throughout the throughout the state. And I'm pretty sure that they would want real-time data immediately, right? Anything.
They're the first responder.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Versus a state senator or an assembly person wanting something that would be at a second level.
Right.
But I could also see them, some of them, one particular senator who's kind of brought this user story to us, wants everything within his district as soon as it's plotted, because he wants to be able to hold his particular county government that he oversees, you know, accountable for, especially when they're a county that says that they don't want to, they're one of the most technologically connected counties in all of the U.S., but yet they don't want to have a countywide 311 system. And so he wants to short circuit or at least engage that county's elected officials and their technology stakeholders to say, we want, you know, obviously we need a 311 look, or we need to figure out how to get to that 311 scenario. And then there's obviously the, you know, the 90 days or maybe the 60 days, or maybe if it's even just particular certain issues that he or she would want to review. I think, so how about privacy issues, in the sense that I know that if there was a button on our NY Senate app that said report an issue, right, and they put it on there, and it's like, my son is unable to get healthcare benefits through the certain thing, you know, here's the social security number,
right.
They're not necessarily looking at the privacy issues, because we've had a number of public people that have commented who have given us a very specific personal information, sensitive personal information, and that's just through a web form. Are there ways of even flagging through your API a public versus private, like, I only want this individual to see this system, and so it still uses the API, still uses the same record management, potentially giving the end user the ability to monitor through the dashboard, but yet the public doesn't see the privacy?
Currently in implementation, only second-tier questions have the ability to be private.
Okay.
Only because we only have dealt with things that are public record at this point, should be public record at this point.
Again, I'd say that also the service request categories drive that conversation. If you if you have them first choose whether they want to report Paul or B,
right.
They're not going to be
submitting social security.
Yeah.
So it's the interface is very important.
Yeah, and
starting with safer categories is.
Yeah.
But it sounds like it's not, you may not be interested in discouraging them. You may be interested in having a place to collect those in the same CRM as well. And so.
Right. I want, just like 311 is a centralized system, I could have, you know, I could still have problems with my getting my Medicaid or,
mm-hmm.
or you know, my handicap transit system isn't working.
Yep.
I still call 311 to find out where do I call to complain or, you know, pass me through.
Right.
It's going through that hotline now, but one gets routed privately and the other one gets routed publicly.
Yeah, it's an interesting question. It just came up in another meeting I was in New Haven where they were talking about we're going to use C-Click Fix for people to request services from the Office of Sustainability, and most of those things are like rain buckets, trees, other pieces of infrastructure, lead abatement programs that might impact your home, but some of them are health related, right? So like having an asthma check on your home might be sensitive information if you don't want the insurance companies looking at it or whatever else,
right.
Whatever crazy reason. I think one possibility which we're discussing for handling those is just that a service request was made to that department. Not necessarily what the specific details of that service request are, so the top tier is some kind of health related service request. I'm not sure that's the perfect solution, but you know, I think it's something we'd definitely welcome feedback on and be interested. It's going to get, I think our concern probably with this has always been that if we, while it's definitely necessary to have private data in many cases, if we start opening the door to that, are we next opening the door to people saying, well, it's really important that potholes be private because, you know, whatever, and now suddenly we're trapped in this conversation on our API of
true.
Which service request types are which are private and which are public.
Yeah.
And that's, I think that's challenging. Because you get down to, like, we've already seen it a little bit, you get down to, like, zoning issues with neighbors, and I think, you know, there is some question of whether that should be public or private.
Yeah. But this past week, you know, just debating this issue has led me to think about who has developed a Yelp for government agencies. So, you know, New York City effectively could be a state, or at least the size of all of its city municipal services, and just think about New York State alone and rating different agencies' effectiveness through the service requests that they fulfill. So, you know, I can't rate Department of Transportation's pothole fixing request system publicly, but how can I rate it publicly? Even if I, you know, is it a good experience? Is it a negative experience? Like even service requests from senators, like where is there a step or where in the future could this potentially be used as a Yelp-like services for government?
That's interesting. Yeah.
I mean, you know, like specifically, this Social Security Administration's office is horrible. The people here, you know, blah, 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 blah. Or I absolutely love these particular services that I'm getting from, you know, this department.
So Noel is leaving New York State Senate and coming to work for C-Click Fix to start a new division, apparently. Congratulations.
Oh, yeah?
I think so.
Is it Yelp Click Fix?
Yeah.
Well, it's finally, there's like the Git for GovData, and now you're like the Yelp for government agencies.
I mean, just think about like the public accountability that exists. I mean, it's really tangential to what C-Click Fix is doing in regards to services, but it also ties directly into if you have an administrator who wants public feedback, and it's totally being squelched internally through the agency. You have a completely open and public and, you know, unsquelchable public conversationalism space.
Yeah, it's interesting because, I mean, with the open data piece, the judgment is tied directly to the response time and how many issues have been responded to. With this, with the Yelp aspect, you're adding an emotional layer to that data, which says that they feel that they were treated well when they communicated.
Mm-hmm.
And that's
so
an important
maybe we
piece
should
well.
Have a hack up here. A couple of developers. And
it would be cool to add a feedback piece into the API. I mean, like a rating or something.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Well, I think before getting into the hack session, there's a lot of infrastructure pieces that need to be teased out, because how much of that Yelp system do you want to use? Do you want to privatize it on Yelp? Do you not? Do you want to just augment CClickFix to have addresses for regional offices, like right your office?
Get Satisfaction as an API, and can you put that onto someone else?
I don't know.
I mean, is Get Satisfaction disruptive in that way? Can you like set
yeah.
up some? It is.
It is, yeah.
That might be one way to do it.
Yeah.
Just to add a layer from them.
But I'm thinking, yeah. I don't want to divert or fork the conversation in any way. But especially since it's 2:00 or 2:07 right now.
I think we just need to decide. This came to us as a senator's idea to do something, and now our instincts are let's do it for everybody, all across the Senate. And so it's just making sure the implications of that. And then it was, let's put it in the app. And so it keeps growing in terms of the functionality we need to make sure that the implications of us saying, taking this on, that we're really working on. It's almost sometimes the language and the caveats of like, where do we put the brand of SQL? Say, this is a public service, so we just need to work through that. I would like to write, like I said, if I can get my laptop up after my next little mobile talk or whatever, I'll try to put a form into the app and see.
Yeah, cool.
See what it would look like, and we can talk about the fields or whatever while we're here.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. And then on the SCF CRM piece, where are you guys at right now with CRM?
Great. I mean, there's a lot. It's kind of rolling out, but I think
And it's Civi, right?
So, yep, Civi CRM. I mean, we're constantly inching ourselves to deployment. It's been a big undertaking. Hopefully, Bluebird, as it's called, will be demoed in a big conversation tomorrow. That's one of the tracks that I'm looking forward to, is really having a 45-minute conversation of Bluebird and kind of like what it is and where it stands. So,
in terms of custom development and building on top of it, though,
mm-hmm.
it's kind of tricky to say because it's so mission critical point right now,
mm-hmm.
of like the mainframe is going to turn off and this thing has to work.
Right.
So doing these other kind of side projects, that's why I think the email integration was like, oh, that's easy.
Got it. Yeah.
Doing cool. module is like, we don't have the bandwidth then.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's 2:10 right now, and I'm really a stickler for time. So thanks, thanks.
Yeah,
hopefully everybody
thanks.
Got this on memory, and thanks the internet.